But when you see those tiny different changes, it can have a huge impact down the road. And who is seeing the worst impacts from what eventually becomes Hurricane Ian? It sees that really starts to take shape as far as the future radar goes as it approaches Cuba and then exits into the Gulf of Mexico. So I'm going to bring back in Dr. Rick Postel. When I look at this cone, the forecast cone, of course, a lot of Florida is in it, and that is concerning. But when I look at it also, we have lots of time still to prepare.
Yeah, we have a lot of time to prepare, and there's still a lot of uncertainty, especially when you get out to days 3, 4, and 5, Molly. Thank you so much for that. Now, here's a live look at Naples, Florida. South Florida people preparing for a possible impact from Ian. Exactly what kind of impact, it's still too early to know, depending on how close it gets. But it feels like the worst of it, for now, will remain offshore of Naples. Of course, that could change, and you're going to want to prepare now, not just in South Florida, but in Central and especially North Florida, because it looks like Ian is coming your way next week, and the weather's going to get worse. Now, when the weather's fine, is the time to take action. So let's talk about where Ian may indeed go. And what I plotted here was a small subset of the model, so I could show you a much bigger subset in a graphic that would make any sense. It would be completely noisy. Why do that? Let's show a subset of the models that are pretty good and have been recently reliable, showing where we think the center of, I should point out, the center of Ian is going to go. Remember, it's a pretty big storm, so the impacts will be spread.